Chili and Friends, Star Party by Polly Dunbar. Tilly and her friends were putting up tents. They were going to sleep out in the garden. "I'm so excited," said Hector. "This is going to be fun," said Tilly.
"I love camping out," said Tilly. "It's like being on holiday," said Doodle. Everyone got cozy in their sleeping bags.
Tiptoe wasn't ready to go to sleep. He saw a beautiful blue star in the sky. It looked lonely. Tiptoe waved at the blue star. The star twinkled back. Tiptoe wanted to play with the blue star.
"Let's ask the star to come down and play," said Tumpty.
"Would you like to come and play?" called Doodle. The star didn't answer. Then everyone called. But still the star didn't answer. Then Tilly had an idea.
Everyone cut out star shapes so they could dress up as stars. "This will make a blue star," said Tilly.
"Mr. Blue Star," said Tilly, "please come and play with us down here." The friends thought food might help, so they made a twinkly midnight snack.
"Bitey, bitey," said Doodle.
Tiptoe tried to reach the star wearing Pooh's tall shoes. That didn't work. Then Tiptoe tried jumping on the trampoline.
"We need something to blast us into the sky," said Tumpty.
"We need a spaceship," said Tilly.
A spaceship was just what they needed.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off!
They flew for miles and miles and miles.
"The blue star isn't getting any closer," said Doodle.
"It's true," said Tilly. "The stars may seem close, but they are very long way away."
Tilly and her friends couldn't reach the star.
"But look," said Doodle, "there's another star."
"And another," said Pooh, "and there's the moon."
Tiptoe was happy to see that the blue star wasn't alone, and he knew he would see it again tomorrow night, and the night after that.
The end.